So check out this brand new way of working between Lightroom and Photoshop, where we can preserve every edit and we have unlimited flexibility. You're gonna love this. Let's select a couple of images and I'm gonna open these in Photoshop. But before I do, you can select which version of Photoshop you wanna use now. Go into the settings menu, and then under Photoshop version, you'll see all the different versions you can choose. How do you get those? I'm glad you asked. Under your Creative Cloud, if you want to add the Photoshop Beta, choose Beta Apps, and then install the Photoshop Public Beta. If you want other versions of Photoshop, see this three-dot menu? Click on there and you'll see other versions. And so you can install older versions of Photoshop, and this enables things like the 3D filters to run, or maybe some filters that are not compatible, but you also want to have access to the newest version, you can install them from here. And when you install another version of Photoshop, it doesn't take away the other versions. In fact, they will all work, and in a lot of cases, they can even run simultaneously. Once you've installed multiple versions, you can go under the Photoshop version, under the preferences, and you can choose the exact one that you want here. When you right-click and you choose Edit In, it's going to use the version that you selected. So now we choose Edit In, and this is the version that's going to be used. But wait, we're not going to edit in Photoshop directly. We're going to go down to Open a Smart Object. So why did I even bother showing you all the different versions? Because this is the version that will be used when we open as the Smart Object. Go down one more. This is the brand new feature, Open a Smart Object Layers in Photoshop. We can select multiple images like I have, and click here. It's going to load that version of Photoshop that we set in the preferences. And if you didn't set a preference, by default, it'll use the latest version. Photoshop will launch, and whatever we selected is going to be here inside the Smart Objects. You can tell the Smart Objects because of this little icon. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. So the advantage in working in a Smart Object is that we can use the tools inside of Photoshop, but still have access to the original edits. Let me show you what I mean. So we're going to double click on the Smart Object layer. It's going to open inside Camera Raw. Camera Raw shares the same processing engine as Lightroom. And if you see these little dots, which are new in Lightroom, but have been in Camera Raw for a while, that means there's edits in these areas. So let's look at the cropping. Let's hit the freeform. We can actually undo that crop. Look at that. Nothing is set in stone. We have access to the original image in every edit. In fact, I'm even going to go further and I'm going to rotate this. And then when we go back, we can see our adjustments. Everything is where we set it in Lightroom. So we can make more adjustments if we want. Click OK. Updates it on the layer. Why don't we reposition this? Control T or Command T. Now you might not do these exact edits. You'll probably do different edits. But I just want you to see what is possible. So why don't we position it here-ish. Straighten it up a little bit. Obviously not going for realism unless we've got a super giant boat. So why don't we hide the ocean here. So I'm just going to quickly go into Effects. Blending options. And let's just roll off the shadows. Hold down the outer option key. And we can just roll that back a little bit. Click OK. Great. Yeah, we can see the water through here. Just pretend it's a glass bottom boat. All right. What about the other layer? Let's have a look at the layer underneath. Let's double click it. And the reason I did that is I want to open up the masks panel and look at this. Yes, we even have access to the masks that we set inside of Lightroom, and we can edit these. We can adjust them later. All right, so we'll make some adjustments there. Click OK. It will update. Now, if I hit Control S to save this file, now I'm going to close it out and go back to Lightroom. Now, this is really important. The first time you bring an image into Photoshop from Lightroom, what it does is it creates a new file. All right, so now it's come back as a TIFF, and we can see it here in Lightroom. And here is the key, listen up. If you want to make any edits to this image, don't go and make any edits here in Lightroom. The best way to do it is to right-click, choose Edit In. Now, this time we're going to use Edit in Photoshop. So remember, when you first open it into Photoshop for the very first time, use Open a Smart Object or Smart Object Layers if there's more than one. every time after that, when we're working on this new file that was created, we're always going to choose open in Photoshop. There's three options. Always choose edit original. These other ones do other things, but I want to keep this tutorial simple. So let's just edit original every time. So when you first do it, edit a smart object. When you want to do it again, edit original. And why should you edit original? Because we go in here, look at this. There's our layered file. All the adjustments that we made are still there. I can double click on here. It takes me into the smart object. Look, the original image is there. Nothing's lost. All the adjustments we made are still there. If this video is helping you, hit that like button. Helps us with the YouTube algorithm. So why would you be tempted to make that adjustment in Lightroom? Well, what if you want to make an adjustment to this entire image? Or you want to apply a preset from Lightroom? How do we do it to everything without flattening it? What we're going to do is hold the Shift key, select both these layers, right click, and now we're going to convert this to a smart object. So what essentially we've done is we've taken those two smart objects and now we've wrapped them in a brand new smart object. So this time, rather than double clicking, we're going to go under the filter and we're going to choose Camera Raw. Here's our image. Why don't we do apply preset? So we're going to go under the presets here. All right, let's grab my Wasteland preset. We can apply that. And if we want to just pump up the contrast a little bit, we can do that. Click OK. So now the preset has been applied to both of these layers. Now, if I hit Control S and I want to save this, we go back to Lightroom and look at this. It updates now. All right, now I'm going to show you how much flexibility is in here. Right click, choose Edit in Photoshop. Remember, always edit in after we've created it, edit original. So there's our Camera Raw adjustment. I could hide that if I wanted, or I could actually just blend it back. Let me double click on the little slider. And why don't we split the difference? There's our original. Just put a little bit of that adjustment in here. Okay, so we can adjust the whole image as a whole. But what if you wanted to access those original layers once again? They're still here. Double click on the smart object. This will open up a new smart object. So this is a nested smart object. And look at this. All our layers and everything are in here. If I wanted to make any adjustments, I could. And why don't we, just for fun, make an adjustment? Let me double click on here. Why don't we warm this up just a little bit? There we go. It's warm. Watch it update. Boom. There we go. Control S to save it. Close it out. Notice it updates in here. And of course, all I got to do is save this. And anytime I save this, it updates it inside of Lightroom. And you're not just limited to two images either. Look at all these layers in here where we can build complex collages. We can do focus stacking. We can do all kinds of things. So we start in Lightroom, we make our initial edits, then we bring it into Photoshop. Do whatever you want in Photoshop, save it, creates a new file here. So the key here is use Lightroom to store these images and organize them so you can find them and go back into Photoshop and make those edits. And now we have maximum editing flexibility thanks to being able to open multiple smart objects as layers inside of Photoshop. If you want to know about all the new features inside of Lightroom Classic, check out my link, my video here or here. It's one of the two. And if you learn anything new, let me know in the comments underneath. And by the way, hit the subscribe button if you're new. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.